married, 2 weeks to the widow Corny. I sold myself cheap, dirt cheap.
Cheap? Are you gonna sit there snoring all day?
I'm gonna sit here as long as I think proper, madam.
What's the matter?
It's old Sally, ma'am. She got something to tell you that must be heard. She got long and short night. Why don't you listen, ma'am?
Well, what is it?
This boy was cared for, from where he was apprenticed to an undertaker, where he ran away from...
Yes, yes, it is very good of you to come. Now, what have you got to tell me?
This locket was given to me by the lad's dying mother just before she passed away.
You say, when he left your workhouse, he went to an undertaker's?
Yes, Mr. Salisbury, the undertaker, took Oliver from us for £3.
You mean to say that you sold him like an animal?
Well, sir... It was Widow Corny who actually authorized the sale.
Really? And I will see that neither of you is employed in a position of trust again. Leave my house.
How dare you speak so to me, sir? I came here to help you.
You came here in the hope of profiting from your own greed and dishonesty.
If you consider the trinket don't properly belong to us.
Here, £10. Take it and consider yourself fortunate that you don't find yourselves in the hands of the law. Mrs. Bedwin, show these ghastly people out.
Yes, sir.
We know the way out, thank you very much.
It was all Mrs. Bumble.
The law supposes your wife acts under your direction.
If the law supposes that, then the law's an idiot.
Mrs. Bedwin, take a look at this miniature. Can you see who it is?
Why, it's Miss Agnes, sir.
Yes, my daughter Agnes. She must have found her way to the workhouse and had a child there.
If only she had told us.
Pardon me, sir, but I've news of all of them.
What is it?
Oliver's in danger. In bad company. I'm the girl who dragged back to Old Stay again the morning he was in this house. And I wish I'd never been in apartments.
You?
Me. And someone else.
Where is this Faggins? And who is this other person you speak of?
I can't tell you. But I'll bring Oliver to you. Not here. It's far from this.
Where then?
Will you promise that I won't be watched or followed?
I promise you solemnly.
Then tonight, between the time of 11 and the time of the clock strikes 12, I will walk under the bridge, and I will make order.
Very well.
Do you think I can trust you, Mr. Bellman?
I'm afraid we have no choice, Mrs. Bedwin.
With no one to take his
a heavy country.
Thank you.